Three factors you have indicated. One is the 21st of June letter. Second is the case of threats. Third is about BJP's. And fourth is about the independence letters. Those two, if we eschew from consideration, because from the opposition side, for him to base his decision, apart from threats, which is purely a law and order situation, what is remaining is the 21st of June 2022 letter. That letter merely informs the governor that we reaffirm that Shinde to be appointed and continues to be appointed as the leader of the house. Number one. Number two, Gogavale will be the whip. You continue to recognize that. Nothing more than that. It doesn't say anything more than that letter.
Allow me to note. This is their reason. I am not justifying, nor can I put myself into the shoes of the governor. And with profound respect, your lordships would also examine not what your lordships would have decided with these facts, but whether there exists.
But what the governor can constitutionally decide. We are not going to go into whether what our view is the situation.
Can you allow me to complete the sentence?
It's the duty and power of the governor.
Can I complete the sentence? This act of our party leaders had a tremendous negative impact upon the voters and the party cadre at large. As an elected member, I am answerable first to my voters, then to anybody else, Malav. Because 39 members can say that we will vote against the party even at the cost of being disqualified and ceasing to be MLAs. Then the governor is faced with a situation where there would be instable government which cannot withstand on its
stand. Which means he is going to the disqualification issue.
No, I'm sorry.
That's the problem.
That 39.
Right. All that you are reading up to PDF page 17, where they passed the resolution. The resolution is at page 17. Huh? There are two parts of this letter. Two parts of the resolution. First part is, let's formulate it. One, the first part is, BJP and Sena had a pre-poll alliance. One. In breach of the pre-poll alliance, the Shiv Sena teamed up with the Indian National Congress and the NCP. Two. Three. By teaming up with the NCP and the Indian National Congress, the Shiv Sena has militated against the core ideology of the Shiv Sena. Four, that there has been corruption in the government. And five, that there is discontent within the cadre of the party. This by itself will not justify the governor in calling a trust vote. Never. That's what our judgments have repeatedly said.
No, already your lordships have said otherwise in Shivraj Singh Chauhan.
The fact that the conduct of a government has gone against the core ideology of that party can never call for a trust vote. Now, what then is in that letter, what then comes in the resolution? Two things. That we reaffirm that Eknath Sambhaji Rao Shinde, who was elected as the leader of the party, continues to be the leader. And two, that Gogole, that we reaffirm that Gogole is elected as the chief whip. Two things. The first part of the resolution has no bearing on a trust vote at all. The first part of it only reflects on the fact that there is grave disquiet among these people that, well, you militated against our pre-poll allowance and the core ideology of the Shiv Sena. That's alien to the governor because they have already come, they have formed government already. Second, what do? They merely reiterate that Eknath Shinde continues to be the leader of the party in the legislative party. How is this a justification for a trust vote?
This is signed by 41 MLAs. Manoj, the difficulties, Manoj, we are trying to examine and analyze the justification given by 34 or 39, whether it could have been a justification for floor test. For governor, he has to only examine that, but for this 39, the government would fall. I would rather go for the floor test.
In which case, he is now saying, you are right. You are absolutely right. You are spot on. There is no difficulty about it at all. Therefore, what the governor is saying is, but for these 39, as you rightly say, the government will fall. Can he look into the fact that but for these 39, the government will fall, when exclusion of these 39 is postulated on the speaker passing an order for their disqualification under the 10th schedule? Until that order is passed, he cannot presume that they are going to be.
He is not.
It's a preemptory move.
Lord, I think we are.
Don't to say that we remain part of that.
Exactly.
We are not cutting company.
My lords are saying the same. My lords,
they say that we continue to be in the Shiv Sena.
Correct, my lord. But still, we don't
they
support
continue the to be in the Shiv Sena. How do you call for a trust vote?
What is the apprehension, lord, that the government
trust has? Vote is not against Shiv Sena. Trust vote is against the government, against the chief minister. Lord, suppose what happens if the leader loses the confidence while members remain? Lord, now kindly see the flip side of this. Flip side is this. Lord, today there is a government of Shiv Sena and BJP. Now your lordships, my lord, prima facie view is that merely because some people go and say that we don't trust this government, governor should not do anything. Not that cannot do anything. Your lordships, prima facie view is this is debate, my lord. I hope this is not the conclusion. Your lordships are only
in a dialogue.
Yes, it's a dialogue. Now suppose today BJP has what, 106 members. Lord, 100 members were to say that we have lost faith in the leader. Even our chief minister, kindly allow.
Right.
Okay, kindly allow me to.
So 106 say we have lost faith in Fadnavis. Okay.
Kindly. Allow me to.
For a moment, postulate it. Yes, you're right. Absolutely. Exactly. You're absolutely on spot on.
Kindly see, my lord. Would your lordships consider giving governor the power to wait for the flow test and ensure that there is some management where the majority is created? That's the flip side of it.
Mr. Solicitor, you can never allow the governor to ask for a trust vote when there is absolutely nothing to shake the majority on the floor of the house. What is the trust vote for? Do you have the numbers in the house? The trust vote is not for determining who is going to be your leader in the house. No. The trust vote, what is the purpose of the trust vote? In a house of 288, do you have 144? That's the purpose. And if there is nothing to indicate that 144 is disturbed, who will lead those 144 is alien to the governor. It may not have been Uddhav Thackeray. They could have elected somebody else. The INC, NCP and the Sena would have said, okay, we're electing somebody else.
Would your losses come to page 21? There is a direct...
That is a matter of internal party discipline, you see. That can never be a matter for the governor. Governor's trust vote is where the majority in the house is shaken. And where was there anything to indicate?
They say, we don't wish to support this government. Meaning,
look, Mr. Mehta, if you will look at para 11, that's the conclusion. We demand security. That's all. They don't say we are parting company. Where do they say that? Lord, they say, please give us adequate security as also our Lord, family because it's
Lord,
withdrawn.
The governor is not, my lord, a court where this prayer was not couched in this manner. He has to, based upon the material before him,
Mr. Mehta, what is being pointed out to you, what is being pointed out it is, this communication cannot be said to be withdrawing the support to Mr. Uddhav Thackeray. Lord, this is that what happened earlier,
what it says. It may say they give us protection, but they say we no longer want to be a part of this corrupt government. Meaning thereby 47 people are minus now.
And they
from the magical mark.
What is being pointed out, then thereafter they don't say further that henceforth, correct, we are not supporting this.
If it is a petition, there is no prayer.
For the subjective satisfaction.
Please note one difference. It's not legislative party members showing lack of confidence in their party. It's not their internal party affairs anymore. These members are saying that we are withdrawing support from the government. Malod, that's the distinction. And Malod, I would hasten to add, Malod, that this not being, Malod, a petition or a suit may not have a prayer clause, etc. But Governor, Malod, as I will show from one para of Bomai, from whatever material, if he comes to the prima facie satisfaction, and that test is accepted by my lords, my lord, in the Shivraj Singh Chauhan judgment, that there is loss of confidence by this government, then he can ask, not only can ask, he should ask the floor test. 47 members of the Legislative Assembly, not just Shiv Sena MLAs, but independents and two members of Prahar Jan Shakti Party saying we are withdrawing support from the government. No, it's past and continuous also. That we have already declared that we don't want to support. But now we are being pressurized to support. That's what. Lord, kindly see. And I'll show, Lord, para 393 Bomai. Lord, from whatever material he comes to a prima facie conclusion that there needs to be a floor test, he would be under an obligation. We don't want to support this government and therefore give us security because we are being threatened. Second, what is the fact situation before the governor? One set of MLAs, namely 47, saying that we want to withdraw support from the government. One set of MLAs, or the leaders of the party saying that we will see when you come on the floor of the house. In my respectful submission, I'm posing a question to myself, would the government not be just, governor not be justified in forming an opinion that the government has lost confidence? I'm not saying anything. I'm not preempting anything. As Mr. Sorabji narrated several possibilities, I'm only asking for a floor test. Maybe they might change their view. Maybe they might sacrifice themselves. Maybe they stand disqualified. Maybe they are persuaded. Maybe the leadership changes. There are several possibilities. The governor, in my respectful submission, will have no jurisdiction once he has a material. And what can be the material, apropos her ladyship's question, it need not be a letter also. Suppose in a given set of circumstances, it's in public media, everywhere, which cannot be disputed. All channels are showing something. But I'm posing a question to myself, can the governor not examine those facts also? But ultimately, he's not just, when a 174-175 situation arises, he's not supposed to be a mute spectator. He will have to act. His action would be subject to judicial review. Within the parameters which your lordships have fixed for my lord's future assistance, my lord justice.
And Lok Prahari and these 17 independent MLAs were backing the government up to then.
Yes. Yeah, yes. Seven, my lord.
Seven.
It need not be a prayer that please hold a floor test, etc., my lord. People are telling him that the government is not enjoying our support. They've lost the confidence. Lord, here I am being asked by the person who did not choose to face the vote of no confidence that why did you call for the vote of confidence? Why did you call for the floor test? The converse situation and more drastic, my lord, in terms of the facts. So, my lord, it's not his right, it's his obligation. And my lord, the threshold in my respectful submission is that some material which creates a doubt in his mind. And my lord, I would, my lord, at the cost of reputation and with profound respect, my lord, please, this is a constitutional submission. Don't my lord, misunderstand the submission. My lord, the threshold of your lordship's judicial review, which I am not disputing, would be whether there was any material, whether based upon that material, your lordships may perhaps have taken a different view, may not be a test. My lord, Shivraj Singh Chauhan was a case of a running assembly and in the midst of the government functioning, the then chief minister lost the confidence. This is what your lordships were dealing with, my lord. Mr. Sibal contends that the observations of the constitution bench in Nabam Rabia on the authority of governor to order a trust vote to be conducted on the floor of an ongoing legislative assembly are purely obiter. But Nabam Rabia was also an ongoing assembly, not first time government formation. But this is in support of what I did as a governor. That if it's not in session and something would turn, my lord, on his written another argument that no confidence motion was the only way and not the confidence vote by floor test. Here, they specifically say in writing that we want to withdraw support from the government. Constitutional role of the governor. But I don't think, my lord, anything more is required to be said by me except, my lord, very respectfully adopting my lord's judicial determination. Lord, all arguments which are made here were advanced, were present before your lordships and my lords were thereafter, my lord, pleased to lay down the law. Para 61. The issue of whether a governor can call for a trust vote in an already constituted legislative assembly is not entirely res integra. Because if this is the correct assessment of the governor, there are two options, either go for a floor test or 356. Which your lordships have frowned upon. Therefore, I say he should not only command the confidence, but continue to command the confidence. That's, my lord, the requirement of democratic functioning. Now, para 68, your lordships were pleased to reject the argument. The argument was that the exercise of power by the governor under Article 174 and 175 should also be based on aid and advice. Your lordships were pleased to, my lord, reject that submission. Lord, I am not, Lord, troubling your lordship with that, my lord. The governor did so on the basis of objective material and reasons which were relevant and germane. My lord, these are the potent words used by your lordships. It should not be irrelevant material or something completely not germane to the issue.